One of the major stories here in northeast Syria is the emergence of a representative form of government that represents all the peoples like the Kurds, Christians, and Arabs. It also preserves religious freedom and emphasizes the role of women.
Called the Self-Administration of Northeast Syria, or SANS, it controls a third of Syria between the Tigris and Euphrates rivers. Some 4 million people live within its borders.
After the Syrian revolution began in 2011, the Assad regime began to pull out of northeast Syria. Then the people of this region had to fight both Al-Qaeda and then ISIS. These two major developments led the people of this region to form a representative form of government not seen in the Middle East before.
Truly, as I have mentioned before, the self-administration of northeast Syria, and also in this management, all the minorities are from northeast Syria, from Kurds, Arabs, and Syrians, and Turkmen, and other minorities.
It's a federal system of government like the U.S., and makes the role of women a priority. The charter calls for 40% of the representative body to be women.
Of course, after the revolution in North and East Syria in 2011, the women in Syria in general, and especially in northeastern Syria, have proven themselves in all fields, and it started with joining the military by joining the Kassadiq forces and the Syrian Democratic Forces in freeing much of the region side by side with the men. And it has also extended to administration. Certainly, a woman can free and support and join in all the campaigns, and she can also be perfect for administrative work.
Why the priority?
Because women are the half of the society. Men and women complete the society.
This village meeting is one of the regional women's centers designed to train women to play a role in society. They've also made a place for Christians.
Because this project is democratic, and for the first time, it has recognized us as Syriac Christians and recognized our language, culture, and even our religion.
As Christians, I think this is our homeland, and this is the cradle of Christianity eventually, and either with our language and culture that was the same language and culture of Jesus Christ, or even through our ability to pray, our ability to build our churches, our ability to gather together and to administrate our religious beliefs.
This Church of the Brethren is the only evangelical church in Kobani. One of the church leaders says this would never have been allowed under the Syrian regime. It's one more sign of the religious freedom under the self-administration of northeast Syria.
The region has given us permission in the context of the administration of northeast Syria. And like this, we will continue. Concerning the church, we can express our rituals with complete freedom.
The new government wrote a social contract in 2014. In their preamble, it states, "The charter proclaims a new social contract based upon mutual and peaceful coexistence and understanding between all strands of society. It protects fundamental human rights and liberties and reaffirms the people's right to self-determination."
It's completely new in the Middle East, and I'd say it's completely new in the whole world.
Freelance journalist Carlos Zuretuza has covered this new government for several years.
What these people are actually doing is rebuilding themselves, starting from scratch after decades of repression by the Assad regime. So literally from day one, since 2012, since they liberated their territories, they are in the process of reconstructing civil society, integrating different components in the region, not just Kurds, it's Arabs, Armenians, Syriacs.
Zuretuza says this unique experiment could be a bridge to the West.
It's very much an experiment which is going on, which is happening for the first time in history, which could spread throughout the region. Because outside here, there's literally nothing similar.
They look to the U.S. and Europe as their inspiration.
I am fond of America. The American people are free. They are a democratic people. And as a region here, we want to create a model like the European countries as people, Muslim, Christians, Yazidis, create a community that is a small Europe in the Middle East.
As U.S. allies, they fought ISIS and lost thousands of men and women.
Today, we have given up martyrs in this region. and the number of martyrs is what has given us the motivation to go back and fight. And we wish from the U.S. President and we wish from the American people that they would not disappoint us and stand with us.
They want the U.S. to play a role in this new democracy.
Truthfully, President Trump is a president of a great country. And we in northeastern Syria, along with the American army and the soldiers of the international alliance, have accomplished much and gained globally, and not only for northeastern Syria, because we fought our biggest terror threat in the world. That's why the great country, USA, should play a role that supports independence and creates a political process that would serve all the minorities that are in northeastern Syria and Syria in general.
Yet Zuratuza says this is a fragile democracy.
The Turkish border is right there. Erdogan has always made his plans very, very public. And the regime is controlling the city center here in Kamishlu. And there's also lots of jihadi factions, Islamists, Daesh, fighting against ISIS, even if it's in its last pocket still going on.
The leaders say their hope is to spread this new democracy throughout Syria, rather than form another country. Whether it can survive long enough to make their dream come true remains to be seen.